Hello, my name is Danny Young. I'm a regional sales director at Surfacide. It's Environmental Services Week, which is a super exciting time, a time to show appreciation for the dedicated EVS teams that ensure healthcare facilities across the country are clean and safe places for patients and staff. We get a chance to sit down with Alan O'Neill, CEO of Unity Medical Center, to spotlight some of the great work being done here. So Alan, thank you so much for joining us. If we could start, just tell us your name, title, where you work, and a little bit of background about yourself.
Absolutely, and thank you very much for the invitation, Dale. My name is Alan O'Neill. I am the CEO of Unity Medical Center in Grafton, North Dakota. Grafton is up in the northeast horse from North Dakota. We're just a stone's throw from Canada and just about on the Minnesota border. So we are really far north. I've been at Unity for about 9 years. I'm a North Dakota native. I've worked in healthcare for almost 40 years now. And I guess the most interesting part was I spent 12 years in Alaska at a hospital in Fairbanks.
That's very exciting up there. I'm sure brought you a lot of beautiful exposure to nature.
Absolutely. And a lot of harsh conditions and unique circumstances too.
Yeah, I'm sure. Well, we understand that UMC was recently awarded a Best Places to Work by Modern Healthcare, which only 40 hospitals in the country receive. So huge congratulations for that. If you could just tell us a little bit more about that award and what Unity did to accomplish this.
Well, thank you. And yeah, we're very honored and very proud of that accomplishment. Actually, we're leaving for Nashville on the 26th to attend the National Awards Gala for Modern Healthcare, as I mentioned, in Nashville, Tennessee. So the award is based solely on employee feedback. They actually do employee surveys, which are confidential. Management has no oversight or review of them before they're submitted. And it's based on the scores of your staff and what they think about working in your organization. Everything from communication to how they're treated, compensation, benefits, I mean, just the whole spectrum. But a lot of it comes down to the culture and what's going on in your organization. And we were going to apply, and this was our first time applying ever. So we were just knocked out of our shoes when we found out we made the list. We were going to apply last year, and we'd actually started some of the legwork. But we were just kind of in the throes of COVID yet, dealing with all those multitude of issues. And every healthcare organization was just fragmented during COVID. And I finally said to the person coordinating, and I think we're going to put this on the shelf for one more year. But this year we picked it up in earnest and got all of the interviews done, the confidential interviews with the employees. And I'd hoped what we'd come back with is a checklist of things we could work on for next year to apply again and maybe make it sometime down the road. But we were just incredibly thrilled and appreciative when our name was called out and we were one of the ones on the short list. And there was two hospitals in North Dakota that made it, but none in the surrounding states that I'm aware of. So we're very, very proud of our team here.
Yeah, that speaks volumes about how happy everybody is there and what you guys are doing to take care of them. That's, I feel like, the biggest award that you could get. So congratulations.
Thank you. And we're very excited about it. And we've certainly let the staff know, and from top to bottom, how much we appreciate them and their feedback. And now we got to roll up our sleeves and try to do it again. So
do it again. The second time is just as hard, huh?
It is. Yeah. Or harder. One of the two.
Yeah. Well, and I think that bleeds into the next question then. UMC recently did a pretty large expansion and update in across the hospital. Can you speak a little bit about the goals for that project and how it's impacted your staff and the community around?
Absolutely. We are a critical access hospital, as I mentioned, in a rural area of North Dakota. The original hospital was built in 1956. There's been a hospital in Grafton for about 110 years. Originally, there was two hospitals, and they came together and formed Unity, hence the name. But obviously, the delivery of healthcare was much different in the 50s, 60s, 70s than it is now. And I mean, you look back in that time frame, there was no, really, there was no air conditioning in any of the rooms. All the rooms were private, or pardon me, semi-private. In other words, they had two or more beds in the room. You look, there were no computers. The, as I mentioned, the air, there was no such thing as air exchange rates being measured and things like that for infection control. And there just was a lack of technology back then. So the hospitals that were built way back when were much different than now. And we started down the path of a redesign in about 2015. And after about 4 years of planning, we broke ground in 2019, but we ended up, we did not do a replacement hospital because the community had made a significant investment with upgrades in some portions of the hospital and clinic. So what we chose to do was to do an addition, which we're very pleased how it turned out. It's three-story, it's about 40,000 square feet. It is, excuse me one second here. Delete something on the screen. 40,000 square feet, three-story. On the first floor, we've got a huge, very contemporary surgical center. We've got rehab services. We renovated part of the old hospital to create an emergency department, a larger one, ambulance garage. And the second floor is all patient rooms. And as you saw for yourself, Danny, they're very large. They're all private. We actually put in two isolation rooms, which this was before COVID was on the radar even. So thankfully we had those rooms when COVID hit. And on the third floor, we have all of our mechanical, including our HVAC, our boilers, everything like that. And we were blessed to have some shell space right across from the boiler room that we've created this fantastic rural medical education training center. And as you saw, Danny, it is a huge classroom that can be subdivided down into three smaller classrooms, plus one smaller, we call it our medical library, and that's where I'm sitting right now, just around the corner. So we're constant, we host a lot of medical students, nursing students, physical therapy, dietary, clinical lab, everything you can imagine. And we're just so fortunate to have all of this education space to host and train the next generation of healthcare professionals. And you mentioned.
Yeah, I have. Oh, yeah.
Go ahead, Dr.
No, I was going to say that I have been to many hospitals, and Unity Medical Center is really one of a kind. So I think it really shows the amount of work you guys have put into it and inviting people to come be a part of what Unity is doing. I think it's really cool.
Well, thank you. The community, we have the University of North Dakota Medical School is 40 miles away down the road. The feedback we've gotten on our clinical education space has been nothing but high level. I mean, they all appreciate it. They're wanting to use it for planning meetings and things like that. And that's wonderful. That's what it was designed and intended for. And our community has really rallied around the new building. We have a whole new team of providers over the last several years and new leadership. And they've really, really been supportive of the organization overall. So we're so appreciative of that.
Yeah, that's great. That's great to see. And again, I think that all of that is showing what bleeds into the work that you guys are doing in the awards you're getting from it, the attention you're getting from it. And so Unity is clearly doing going above and beyond to innovate and create an exceptional environment for patients and staff. Surfacide UV technology has been in your facility for a couple of years now. If you could talk a little bit about UV, can you tell us why you took a look at UV technology and more specifically Surfacide?
Absolutely. So as we went through our design process, the architects and engineers that were involved in the design spoke to the improved air handling that we have now. We actually have UV technology in the HVAC, built in the HVAC. So it does scrub the air that comes out of a couple different departments, mainly the emergency department and surgery. So we have that going for us, but we wanted to take it to another level and actually get into all of the patient treatment areas and just make sure we had exhaustive efforts at creating a clean, sterile environment as much as we can. So we started shopping and looking around at the UV technology, and we decided we did not compromise on our building, on our design. We're not going to compromise with our UV technology. We wanted the very best. And that's what led us to Surfacide. And the reviews I read and just the feedback, and you could tell the R&D, everything that was put into it, there was no doubt this was above and beyond anything that's on the market. And the portability of it, the functionality, it's easy to use. And we have folks that are assigned to using when a patient discharges or leaves a treatment area. Boom, those carts are wheeled in on the robots, we call them, the three robots going in there. And it gets up and running within minutes, and we feel very confident. And this is after the terminal cleaning is done by our environmental services staff. And they do a wonderful job. But the Surfacide just takes it above and beyond, takes it to another level. And we feel confident and comfortable that we're creating the safest patient environment that we can.
How much of that, how much did the pandemic and COVID change any of that? Or was were you guys just focused on this before the pandemic?
You know, I think we were focused, but obviously it took it to another level. Because when, you know, COVID first was coming out, they're talking about how it can be transmitted and so on and so forth by touch, by hard surfaces, by all of these things. Then there was just, we knew we needed to up our game as high as we could to make sure that we were getting that taken care of. So it's at another level, and we're very confident with what we have going on with it. So.
Absolutely. Now let's shift back to your team at Unity. So your EVS staff are dedicated to creating cleaner spaces throughout the hospital and work the closest with Surfacide UV technology. What has their experience been with the robots? Do you know, have you had much experience with them talking about it?
Absolutely. I interface with them a lot. And I think there's a sense of pride for those that are operating the equipment. It's like a unique special skill set. It's kind of, people are in awe when they see those things rolling down the hallway, and it's like, look out, here comes Surfacide. I mean, they literally step aside for Surfacide, I'll say. But they are very proud to be doing that. I think they take a real level of satisfaction in their job when they're operating it, because they know they are creating a very safe environment for patients. And there's just a lot of employee pride that goes with it. And there's no noise. It's not disruptive at all. It's very high tech. You know, it has the little iPad type device that you control everything with. And it's very well designed and engineered. I mean, I can't say enough good about it.
Oh, great. I'm so glad to hear that. When I think that the amount and great work that your team is doing speaks to the great leadership that they've seen from you and all of your leadership there at UMC. So I know personally you're the current board member or board chair of North Dakota Hospital State Association, and you just received the Grassroots National Award from the AHA, which only one person per state receives. So again, huge congratulations to you. If you could just speak very briefly about what those awards mean to you and what your goals are for the future of continuing healthcare in your area.
Well, thank you. Yeah, it's quite an honor. But, you know, healthcare is a team sport. I mean, it's all about the team. And if you're lucky enough to get team members that are committed and willing to be part of an ever lifting or improving culture, that's what it's all about. And we're very passionate up here, even though we're in a rural area. We know we're challenged with a lot of the things that happen in rural. We don't have access to a lot of the amenities or resources that large cities do, so we have to make do. But going forward, we're just very committed to providing outstanding patient care as best we can in as safe of environment as we can. And that's really what it's all about now, is, you know, patient safety. And when you implement something like this, it is like the Surfacide technology, and knowing you've got the best of a brand out there, best of breed out there, it's, you know, you're doing as much as you can for patients and to keep them and their families safe, and your employees too. I mean, if you can mitigate any disease, virus, whatever, before it gets a toehold, That's what it's about. It's about safety. I mean, all of the measures now are on safety and quality, and the clean environment is like the foundation of all of that.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thank you so much for taking the time with to chat with me today. Is there any last things you want to say?
Not much, except kudos to all of the folks on the research and development team that designed this wonderful equipment. And again, I'm not easy to please, I'll say that. So this was not an easy sell for me. We did our research, we did our studies on the what was available out there. And this is not the least expensive approach in the market either, but it's kind of one of those things, you get what you pay for. And in healthcare, and especially speaking in a rural, getting cost-based reimbursement, this kind of equipment obviously is factors into our Medicare cost report. So that's a little plug for the CFOs that are listening, that it's the federal government recognizes the importance of this type of equipment. So it does factor into your cost report, something you'll get a return on. That's a good ROI, as we say.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much. We appreciate it. And continuing best of luck to you and your career and the success at UMC there.
Thank you, Danny. Thank you very much to you and your team.
Thank you.